Hey guys, let's do some hardware hacking in this video. The transmitter that I have here is a FlySky FSI6S, which is one of the best transmitters that you can get for under $100. It supports 6 as well as 10 channel receivers, and the best thing about this is that it has this USB port, so you can play flight simulators by directly plugging this transmitter into your PC. It's all awesome until you realize that this shit consumes power more than an American guy consumes beer. You need to replace its 2 pair of AA batteries for every 2 or 3 hours of use, and the worst thing of all, it still consumes power when you are playing on a simulator and it is plugged in through that USB. This thing can literally make you come to the road, so let me help you to stay in your home by making this thing chargeable. The reality is, you don't need a whole lot of components for this hack or update. You just need a flat lithium battery, a TP4056 lithium charge and protect module, and since I will be using transmitter's USB port, I will use the module without a USB socket in it. And the last one is a boost converter. You can use any other boost converter, but never use the boost converter that I have shown in my previous video. So check it out. Putting that aside, the next thing to do is dismantling the transmitter. Initially, I had thought that the screws might be hidden in the battery compartment, but no, they are actually hidden under the rubber grippers. And by removing them, we can get to the screws and finally remove them. After that, we can separate the wires, and then the two halves can go apart. Now we can work on our way around installing that flat lithium battery on the back battery compartment of the transmitter. Those springs for AA batteries were getting in the way, so I had to remove them. A bit of force and a flathead screwdriver is sufficient. I am using Kapton tape for insulation so that the battery won't short inside the compartment, and when it is done, I can push the positive wire of the battery through the hole in the positive terminal, and the same for the negative wire as well. And after this, my battery seems to fit inside pretty well with some minute adjustments. After placing the battery is done, then we can cut the battery connector because we need it later. Now we need to set up our boost converter to give 5.5 volt at the output. Doing this is also pretty simple. Just connect the power supply of 3.3 volt at the input and slowly rotate the potentiometer until you see roughly 5.5 volt at your multimeter. After that, we can connect our battery with the lithium charge and protect module. Be sure that you don't mess up with the battery polarity, or the result will be not so pleasing. Connect negative to B- and positive to B+ terminals. To connect the boost converter, I am using some extension wires. Connect out minus of the TP4056 module to the boost converter negative voltage input, and out plus of the module to the positive voltage input terminal. Now we need to connect the boost converter's output with the battery connector that we had cut earlier. Do mind the polarity before soldering. And after this, work on this half of this transmitter is almost done, and we need to do a little bit of work on the other half. As we are going to make our transmitter charge through the same USB port, we need to remove this. You might say, why don't we solder the wire directly on the USB power input pad on PCB? And the short answer is, you cannot, because there is no power coming through the USB to the main PCB or this one. To get to the micro USB port, we need to separate this. And desoldering this piece was pain in the ass, but anyhow, I finally did it. All you need to do now is to solder a wire precisely on the rightmost pin of the USB, as I have shown here. And be sure that your solder wire is connected properly and it does not create a short circuit with other pins. And after the soldering of that wire is done, we need to put these two pieces together and solder them back again. Be sure to put some hot glue so that the wire does not come out. And if unfortunately it does, then we have to repeat the same process once again.
Then we have to rescrew them back together.
As we want to see our battery level on the on-screen display of the transmitter, we need to do a bit more work here. The resistor you see, which is 10 kilo ohm, needs to be desoldered and soldered back again with a 6.8 kilo ohm resistor as shown in this image, and attach a wire to one end of that 6.8 kilo ohm resistor, which will be attached to the battery positive terminal to display the battery level. Also add hot glue to wire so that it won't fall apart. You can skip this very next step, but I am adding this LED to let me know when the battery is charging and when the battery is full. The LED will be connected to TP4056, which I will show you to do in a minute. After this, we will connect the wire that is soldered from the micro USB port to positive input of the TP4056 module. Then we can solder the voltage sense wire of the transmitter to the battery positive terminal. I am removing the first LED from the board so that I can solder the wires from that external LED. After this, all of the electronic work is done, so we can now plug the battery to check if everything is working correctly or not. Now let's connect USB to the transmitter's USB port. LED is glowing, which means that our battery has started charging. And if you power it up, everything seems pretty good. So let's fix these two modules in a proper place with the help of some hot glue. Also, managing the wires is necessary as they can create a lot of mess inside the transmitter. As the last thing inside the transmitter, I added hot glue to the battery lid cover so that no one can open the battery compartment and harm our lithium battery, as they are very volatile. After all of this, we can now finally close the lid of the transmitter by re-screwing all of its screws back. Now, there is only one last step to go. Click on TX-RX icons. Then, set the high voltage to 5.4 volt, alarm voltage to 4.7 and low voltage to 4 volt. It is the correct voltage setup for a lithium battery, and if you want to know how I did the calculations, then you can contact me through the Instagram or Patreon page. And at the very end, I did one extra step, which is drilling a small 2mm hole so that I can see that small LED glowing when my transmitter is charging. Note that the LED will stop glowing when the battery is full, but you can still see the battery level on the on-screen display. And after adding the rubber grippers to the sides, this transmitter is no different than a regular transmitter in terms of external appearance, but now it will never use AA size batteries. I have put a lot of effort in making this video, so hope you will appreciate my effort and subscribe to my channel. To those people who are here with me till now, here are some bloopers. Enjoy!
Hey guys, let's do some hard. The transmitter that I have is a Flyskay FS-I6. FS-I6S, which is one more second, the one thing. Hey guys, let's.